Good morning, everybody. Let me introduce myself and our team. My name is Vladimir Anisimov. I am chief of Department of Carcinogenesis and Oncourology at Petrov National Medical Research Center of Oncology in St. Petersburg. Professor Zharinov is head of Radiology Department at Russian National Center of Radiology and Surgical Technology. Was opened in 1918. Our institute was opened in 1927. Dr. Bogomolov and Dr. Niklasova working together with Professor Zharinov. Dr. Chapurnaya work in the St. Petersburg Clinical, Scientific and Practical Center for Specialized Types of Medical Care. Low picture. It's picture of 3 hour institute. Next couple words about history of our research. In 1961, Dr. Mordechai Schwartz published paper showing that patients dies when the tumor reaches its critical size, approximately 10 in 13 power. The survival of patients depends on the tumor rate. There are a lot of data on tumor doubling time. Mainly paper devoted proliferation, but cell loss, which very important part of the natural history of tumor growth, is much less page papers. In 1989, it was shown for the first time, Dr. Zharinov Igushin, that in the patients of cervical cancer, that patients who have fast growing tumors have less cell loss than people, women who have cervical cancer slowly growing. It is second paper by Gennady Zharinov. Our team shown that cellular loss plays a principal role in tumor growth. You see, local prostatic cancer have much more cell loss frequency in comparison to metastatic. Balanced therapy is non-damaging treatment aimed at maintaining balance between proliferation and cell loss in order to increase the lifespan of cancer patients. Efficiency of combined treatment of prostatic cancer patients was improved by use of melatonin as an element of balanced therapy. History of melatonin rather short. It was firstly isolated. Melatonin was firstly isolated in 1958 by Aaron Lerner from pineal gland of calf. In 1973, we have shown melatonin inhibits mammary tumor in mice. It was first paper on this matter. In 1974, melatonin was discovered in enterohemophilic cells in intestines and some other tissue by Igor Kvitnoy. In 1980, it was shown by IF22, France, Paris, the age-related decline, production, secretion of melatonin. Walter Perpauli in 1987 firstly published paper, The Melatonin Increased Lifespan in Mice. And Russ Reiter from San Antonio, Texas, showed melatonin is potent antioxidant. On this picture, you can see that melatonin inhibits tumorigenesis in rodents at a lot of size, localization, mammary, cervix, colon, skin, soft, liver, lung. Majority was done in our lab. We also study effect of melatonin treatment in stomach cancer and colon cancer patients. Recurrence time was extremely increased by 27% in patients with stomach cancer. Meta-analysis of 10 randomized trials showed decrease in 1 year mortality up to 0.66 in solid tumor patients. It's some illustration of our research. Melatonin sufficiently inhibit colon carcinogenesis induced by dimethylgitrazine in rats. It's accomplished by the depletion of mitotic index and stimulation apoptosis. Tumor incidence was dramatically decreased. Another paper was published in International Journal of Cancer. We have shown the constant elimination increase accelerated the mammary carcinogenesis in transgenic mice. A treatment with melatonin inhibit expression of this oncogene at decreased number of tumors, size of tumors, and number of tumors per animal. Thus, let me show design of our study. It was involved 955 patients with prostatic cancer, which received combined treatment, hormonal and radiation, since 2000 up to last year. Treated group, 396 patients, which treated with melatonin, peros orally 30 minutes before sleeping, except winter, because winter level of melatonin is good enough. Control groups was not treated. Melatonin, it was 559 patients. Groups was subdivided according to prognosis. Good prognosis, favorable prognosis, localized prostatic cancer, intermediate prognosis, locally spread. At metastatic prostatic cancer, it's bad, poor prognosis. It much maximum number of patients. Main result are shown on this slide. Good prognosis and intermediate prognosis have not strong effect on survival of prostatic cancer patients. However, median survival of melatonin treated poor prognosis patients was more than two times higher than in control group, 64 months for control group and 153 months treated with melatonin. We conclude the method of balanced therapy improved the survival of cancer patients. We plan to continue studying the factors influence the rate of tumors, growth, proliferation, and cell loss in cancer patients. At present, we have data on good effect of melatonin in breast cancer in women and endometrial cancer in women. But melanoma was unsuccessful. Thank you for your attention.